Hello and welcome. My name's George, and my channel is all about helping you get the most out of Logic Pro so that you can record and produce your best music in your home studio. Today, I'm going to be sharing with you five of my favorite workflow tips that might be a little bit lesser known. So I hope these help you, and let's dive in. First feature I want to share with you is how you can import settings from another Logic project. So this can be either channel strips or content or anything you want from a different session without actually opening up the other session. So all you have to do is go up to the File menu in Logic and go to Import, and we're going to click on Import Logic Project. And then in the Finder window, simply open up the Logic project that you want to import from. Click Import. And that'll open up this window here. And if you have different project alternatives, well, then it'll ask you from which alternative do you want to import. I'm going to go ahead and click OK. And now from here, let's say I want to import the plugins from this vocal track that I have here. So we have a few different options. We can choose to import all the content, so that's going to be the actual audio recordings and files, or we can do just the plugins on that track, and we can add the sends that we want as well. So if we have any reverb or delay on sends, we can import those too. And we can choose to keep the input and output routing the same. And this is keep bus number. We can import automation if we want, or any additional notes. In this case, I'm just going to import the plugins and sends. Now you can either add these to a new track, or you can replace a current track that you have already in your current session. I'll go ahead and hit add. And then when you're dealing with sends, it's going to be adding additional tracks as well. So it'll ask you if you want to add those. I'm going to go ahead and click add all. And now I have this track here with all the plugins that I had in my other session, as well as all the sends. So I have my delay, my vocal reverb, and my ambience reverb. So this is really helpful if I have a vocal chain that I liked from a different track, or if I'm mixing several songs from the same project and there's some settings that I want to use throughout the different songs, then that's an easy way to get them in to a new session. Now, the next feature I want to share with you is the low latency mode. So when we're recording in Logic, if we have a project with a lot of tracks, a lot of software instruments, and a lot of plugins, then sometimes your computer will bog down a little bit and will get latency when we're recording. So let's say I'm recording my voice and I'm listening to my headphones. That means I'm going to hear my voice in my headphones slightly delayed, and that can be a little bit jarring and might not make for a great performance. So one of the ways we can counteract that is to use the low latency mode feature. So to access that, you just go up to the record heading, and then go down to low latency monitoring mode. And now when I record enable my vocal track, you'll notice that some of these plugins are in orange. So what's happening is that these plugins are now going to be bypassed because these plugins are introducing latency to my project. So Logic is just temporarily disabling those to help computer power and make it so that we have less latency. Now, it did the same to my sends down here, but if, for example, I want my reverb regardless, I don't want to record my vocal without hearing a little bit of reverb, you can simply just right-click in here and go to low latency safe. And then you'll see that that re-enabled that. So if there's some plugins that you definitely want to keep on, you can do that too. Now this next feature can be really handy if you're messing around and playing some stuff, but you forgot to hit record in Logic and you want to retrieve what you did. So this is the capture record feature. So for example, I have this Alchemy synth pulled up. I'm going to go ahead and hit play, and I'm just going to play around a little bit. Okay, so let's say I played that and it's something I'm happy with, but I didn't hit record, but I want to retrieve it somehow. The capture record button is there to save you. So if you go up here, you'll notice this little kind of record looking button, but not quite the record button. This is the capture record button. And now if I click on that, there you go. There's what I played. Now, if you're not seeing this button, you can either simply hold down Shift-R, and that'll function the same way, or what you can do is go up here to this little pull-down, and this will be a little bonus tip for you. Go to Customize, Control Bar, and Display. And here, you can add in the Capture Record button, and you can also add in the low latency button while you're at it as well. Now, one thing that can sometimes be frustrating when we're dealing with MIDI is I'm just going to solo this track for once. If I start my playback in the middle of a note here, Logic generally isn't going to play that note when it started in the middle. You'll just hear it once the playhead gets to the next note. But there's an option called Chase MIDI, which will allow us to do that. So for that, we're going to go to File menu, and then we're going to go to Project Settings, and then to MIDI. We'll go to where it says Chase, and then we can enable notes here. And let's close this. And then now when I play it from the middle, it still triggers that note in the middle there. So no matter where I press play, I'm going to hear that MIDI note. And my last feature that you might not know about is the plugin link button. So this is really handy if you have a lot of tracks and a lot of plugins, and you end up having all these windows open and you're a little bit confused of what belongs to what. So for that, let me just quickly open up a different session. Okay, so I have this session with, you know, a number of different tracks and instruments here. And if I have a few of these open at the same time, it can sometimes get a little bit confusing, you know, for which track these belong to. And I want to make sure that when I'm changing any settings that they actually correspond to the right track that I want to do. So what I find helpful sometimes is to enable this little link button up here. And when you turn that on, it's purple. So now if I have my piano track opened up, let's say I click on my cello track. Now the plugin is automatically going to change to that cello track. And any track that I highlight in here, that plugin is going to open up. So let's say I have two of these massive plugins. Now I know that this one corresponds to this track. So if I make any changes, I know I'm changing this track. And if I want to make any changes to this one, then I simply click on that one. So I find this really helpful, as I said, just to make sure that you're actually accessing the correct instrument for the track that you want, and you're not making some changes to a different track by accident. And of course, you can always turn this off, and now if I click on a different track, that's not going to change what's happening here. So I myself find that really helpful. So I hope you found these features helpful, and hopefully they can help you in your own process and workflow. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave those in the comments below. And I want to thank you as well for all your likes and subscribes. And before you go, don't forget to download my free Ultimate Logic Pro Starter Pack. This includes my Logic Pro hotkey cheat sheet, my audio recording checklist, my mixing guide, my gear guide, and my Logic Pro session templates. I hope you enjoyed the video, and we'll see you in the next one.